presented by Church Tech U. It's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to quickly pull up scripture in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name is Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever needed to pull up scripture really, really fast, go ahead, like, subscribe, and tell someone about this video so that they can know how to do it as well. So this stems from a conversation that we had over on the official ProPresenter users community on Facebook. If you're not a member, you should be. TDM.fyi/PPUG will take you directly there. Answer the questions, that's important, and then I'll let you in. So, if you've ever been in a situation, I know that some churches you're in this situation all the time, other churches you're rarely in this situation. Either way, it's good to know how to do this quickly. So let's head over to my computer and I'll show you exactly what I mean. So here we are in ProPresenter 7, and first thing you're going to do, if you suspect, hey, I need to pull up scripture lickety-split, just click on the Bible app right up here. You can also get to that, at least on the Mac, it's Control-B. I believe it may be Control-B on Windows, it may be Alt-B. Either way, try it. And you'll notice that I've got a couple of different versions here. I'm just going to get it down just to make it simple as possible. So imagine that someone hops up and you have this feeling that they're about to call for scripture, or maybe your pastor is about to call for it in the middle of the sermon in a place where it was not indicated ahead of time. How can you get to that real quick? Well, there are abbreviations that you can use to get there really fast. So where it says scripture look up here, just type GEN 1:1, and that'll take you to Genesis 1:1. Well, Paul, what if I need the next verse? Well, down here, just click on this little verse here, and it will continue to add them. But if, let's say that and once you do that, you can just click on this, and it'll put it up right then and there. So you may be saying, well, what if the person, whoever it is, deacon, elder, pastor, whoever, indicates ahead of time, hey, I'm going to do a larger block of scripture, you know, says, now in Genesis chapter 1, verses 1 through 3, it says, well, do the same thing, GEN, 1:1:3, and that takes you there, right lickety-split. Fast as fast can be. So you're good to go there. Now you may be saying, well, how can I get this to be formatted in a way that I like? Well, if you go up here to the upper right hand corner ahead of time, go ahead and click the options button and then select the theme right here. So I've got this black sermon text theme that I can use. I've got other themes that I can use. Doesn't really matter which theme I choose as long as it's appropriate to the situation. Also, keep in mind that the looks presets up here, upper right hand corner, they will apply the theme on the fly so that if you have an alternate theme, so if we click down edit looks, notice I've got an alternate theme for alpha here. So if I go down here to this alpha, it did apply that theme. Now I didn't actually check what the alternate theme was, so yeah, it may have been, let's go down here, edit looks again. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got a either a 1 or a 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to tdm.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to tdm.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. Yeah, it was one of my two language themes, and that one's a little funky because of the multiple text boxes and stuff. So may have been confused there. But I would guess if I switch to this one, yes. So look, see, I'm still in Bible mode. And I've got an alternate theme here that makes sense for it to show. And so this way is it's showing here on the audience screen and for my alpha screen, which maybe we're pretending that's for my live stream, it shows up there. So that's a way around that. Now, if you know, hey, anytime that we're going to show this scripture just off the cuff, it needs to be formatted a totally different way than it ever needs to be formatted. Well, you can also put an alternate theme. I don't normally encourage this, but you can put an alternate theme for all of your screens to format it whatever that totally different way is and have it format on the fly, whereas with the options here, this theme, it would format it maybe the way that it you've got it saved so that it formats the way that you normally do scripture during the sermon, for example. So knowing that you can do these abbreviations, so usually it's like the first three letters. So in my life group last time, we were looking at Psalm 31, so I think PSA will probably take us there. And yes, and it's showing Psalm 31. So that's just quickly there. Remember, as long as you've got the Bible version installed, you can also switch between these. So maybe your church tends to use King James, maybe they tend to use NLT, maybe they tend to use NIV, whatever. If you have that version installed onto ProPresenter, just make sure that you have communicated if there's a chance that it's going to be a totally off-the-wall version, that you're totally cool with the Holy Spirit moving, you just need the person to tell you if it's an unusual translation. If it's not the default translation, then by all means, just tell me that it's the NLT, and then I can go down, and if I have that already, then I can select that there. So, I don't want to get into the theology of pulling up stuff on the fly and any of that stuff. I'm just providing the answer. If you're in a situation where, hey, I need to pull this up, that's the way to do it. First three letters of the book, and then the number for the chapter, space, the number for the first verse, space, the number for the last verse. And that'll do it like that. And then you can navigate down at the bottom with the next verse and previous verses if you need to. If you've brought that up and the person goes, actually, let's read one verse earlier, then you can hit the previous verse. If they continue reading, hit the next verse and click that. So you can do it very quickly. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/pro7 and quick. Give me your name and email address and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.